Alright, hello again. Thank you for watching my second video vlog thing. So as you probably noticed, I don't have really good editing software. In fact, it's very, very outdated. And I also don't have any programs like After Effects or anything, so yes. Okay, music. Today's topic of this week's topic of discussion. And if it looks like I'm reading this from my screen, I'm not. I'm praying. No, okay. Okay, take two. I grew up in the church and I went to a Christian high school, and one of the topics that came up more than once was about Christian music. And you know, I was thinking, what does that even mean? So to try to answer that, just for the heck of it, I thought, you know, I'm just gonna like split music into 8 different categories about this. So here we go. So first of all, there's church music, which is like, you know, stuff you hear in church, like Hillsong or hymns or whatever. Okay, second of all, there's Christian music, which is like, Christian themed lyrics, whether it be something like Jeremy Camp or like Disciple. Alright, next there's just music by Christian bands, like Reliant K or August Burns Red. It's just music by Christian bands, not necessarily, you know, Christian themes, just whatever. Next, there's music by bands who have Christians in them. They don't call themselves a Christian band. They're Christians, but they're just in a band and make music. Why not? So like Evanescence or Switchfoot. Okay, next there is neutral music. It's just neutral, like jazz or classical. Okay, number 6, there's mainstream music. It's just music. Like mainstream bands. Music. Whatever. Alright, then there's negative mainstream music. Like with themes of like negative things like, you know, sex and drugs and affairs and bad relationships, rebellion, hate, violence, war, alcoholism, stuff like that. And there's a lot of really negative music out there, I find. Even if you enjoy the stuff, it's just not positive. I listen to it too, but... And then finally, on the other side, there is anti-Christian music, or anti-religion music, like you said. Nine Inch Nails, which is, I guess there's a lot of like metal bands that fall under this category. But really, if you asked me if I had to choose between Christian music or secular music, I would actually choose secular music, just because I find it better. I do, honestly. I find secular music better. Most of my favorite bands are secular. Maybe they're not better lyrically, but I don't know. That's just my opinion. But yeah, this was all just like modern stuff too. Don't even get me started on like old music, like swing or jazz or honky tonk or bop or any other music you're probably too young for. So in my opinion, the band Disciple is the greatest Christian rock band, or at least my favorite. I mean, really, their old stuff, it's hard-hitting, it's great, it's awesome rock music, but also the lyrics, he takes the lyrics from the Bible, and if you buy the albums and you get the leaflet in the CD, it has the lyrics, it has the scriptures, references that he takes the lyrics from, and it also has like a brief explanation of what he wrote the song about, which is awesome. I mean, where else do you find that? Is there any band that has actually gotten better instead of worse? I mean, I have yet to think of any. Some stay the same, like Alter Bridge. Alter Bridge has had like 4 albums, and I think they're all good, but they haven't gotten better. I can think of like hundreds of examples of bands that have just gotten worse. Hundreds. I can think of every band as an example that has gotten worse. Or at least in my opinion, worse. Like, you know, you like the first few albums and then just worse and worse, and then by the end you're like, oh, great, another album from them. Why didn't you stop, like, years ago? Can you think of an example of a band that has gotten better instead of worse? And I mean, like, better. I don't mean like their first album was crap and then they got better, because I mean that happens a lot. That's how it works. So it doesn't matter what month of the year it is, there will be days when I have Christmas music in my head. Okay, so the problem with classical music is that when you have a song in your head, you can't Google what it is. You can't just like type in da 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 lyrics, enter. You can't do that. I mean, in a normal song, you just type in, you know, the chorus, lyrics, and then the name will pop up, but you can't do that with classical music. So if you listen to music on shuffle, I do that a lot, but then two consecutive songs, it's supposed to be on shuffle, they're not supposed to be in order, but then, wait a second, that is technically on shuffle, that is technically random, because actually it's beyond random, it's taken random and gone 360 degrees back to order. That's the ultimate random. You've probably, unfortunately, heard the song Party Rock Anthem. That's not party rock. That's not even rock. That's just some crappy party anthem song. You know who is the real party rock anthem? Andrew W.K.
Explosion voice. So, I'm gonna do this next section in this voice. So, metal and church music. Right, now let me rant. I would listen to almost any kind of...
Actually, I changed my mind. That was too hard to do the whole thing in. So, I'm just gonna do my normal voice. Sorry. I know you're disappointed. But anyway, I will listen to almost any kind of music. In fact, There's a handful that I really like. And actually, I have an extremely eclectic music library, just as or more diverse than yours. Seriously. But above all, I am a metalhead. I love my metal. Any and all of it. Slow and or fast, new, old, soft, heavy, Christian, secular. All of it. Yeah. From all over the world. Your list is great. I love it. It makes me unique. Unfortunately, I often feel really out of place. Did that camera just jump? Unfortunately, I feel really out of place. Like in church or other gatherings around Christians where Christian music is played. Like church music or worship music. And I'm not saying I hate it or disagree with it. Or find it offensive. But I just don't like 75% of it. It's often slow, repetitive, boring, embarrassingly simple, and include generic lyrics that make me roll my eyes, or at least tune out. Obviously, I like some of it.
If his people prayed!
But more like the upbeat stuff, or even some old hymns. But some of those hymns have actually been modernized and remade. And not only that, but these remakes they're usually worse, like duller or slower or, I don't know, more depressing. And I guess that's just kind of like what Christian, like modern church worship music sounds like to me. It's like, what are we doing? Are we praising God or are we attending someone's funeral?
Crown him many crowns, the Lamb upon his throne.
Now, I don't like feeling this way, and I am trying. But is there nothing I can do about it? Like, just suck it up and take it? Like, endure it for a couple of hours? And, I don't know, just try to embrace it as much as I can? I don't know. Imagine being a very healthy, fit, and active person. And you like to be busy, and you're always getting up earlier than most, and you do stuff constantly. And then one weekend you travel up, stay at a friend's house, and say there's a few of you, all friends, away for the weekend. And you plan on spending the whole weekend together, but all they want to do is sleep in, laze around, just watch movies, or eat unhealthy junk food. You would just feel really out of place, right? I know that was a terrible analogy, but maybe you'd feel annoyed. That's kind of how I feel among church gatherings with, like, church music. And it is kind of annoying and sad on my part. But in fact, back in high school, I even wrote an essay about Christians and metal, and metal in Christianity. Anyway, one of the points was the fact that the music was a reason why some people would never set foot in church. I know this is a minor point, but anyway, what I'm trying to get across is I don't know what to do. Someone actually told me not to feel ashamed of this. Just accept it. It's who you are. It's how God made you. And yeah, He made me unique in this way. But I don't know. At the same time, I feel. How do I feel about this? What can I do about this? And the problem is, I have yet to meet someone who feels the same way about me, or about this, as me. And also, the purpose of like praise and worship music is to praise and worship God, right? Okay, simple. But how am I supposed to do that when praise and worship music either annoys me or bores me? I don't know. What do you guys think? Post a comment, please. Sorry for the rant. Also, at least there is such thing as like praise rock. Like, for example, this. Or this. Or even like praise metal. Like this. We cry holy, holy, it's the realm. There was one king, one name, and one god, and he's made us immortal. That's the carriers of might for the everlasting one. In my life, be lifted high, in our world, be lifted. Luckily for me, but of course you would never hear that in church, unless you go to a unique church. Okay, so I'd like to read you something that I found online, which I think is absolutely brilliant. Okay, I'm paraphrasing to keep it short. As a metalhead, I've gotten used to listening to music in public that I wouldn't listen to by myself. I'm not just grumpily tolerating it, I honestly don't mind some of it. If people legitimately enjoy the music they're playing, then I support that. It's still music after all. But this attitude is almost never reciprocated. I was at a party earlier, and the music ran out at one point. I suggested I put on some chilled out music. Fully aware that the people around me detested metal, I was absolutely not about to put on metal. And yet I got skeptical looks, and I was told that people wouldn't want to listen to my music, and a bit of a disagreement followed. I'm offended for two reasons. Firstly, why the hell not? People seem to tolerate listening to each other's music all the time, across a wide range of genres. Why is metal an exception? Secondly, knowing metal wouldn't be tolerated, I wasn't even suggesting it. And yet, even though I described it as ambient, people assumed I was trying to sneakily get some metal in without them noticing, like they wouldn't. So I'm insulted because my friends seem to think that I'm so socially unaware that I wouldn't accommodate their distaste of metal. He goes on about similar stories of suggesting other music in his library, like to play the Fratellis. Or other like pop rock stuff or whatever, and just getting prejudged. Sorry, can't read. Prejudged, yes, and like they would automatically hate his music, or thinking all he listens to is this horrible death metal. He ends with the question, "Why the intolerance?" And he's completely right. I checked and hundreds of people commented on this online about similar feelings and similar stories, and I totally agree. If you saw my music library, you would see at least one song from every musical genre you can think of, seriously, and I pride myself in that. My brother knows. He knows. Even my mom was shocked at how diverse my library is. So it just so happens that half of my music is metal. So what? I feel metalheads get a bad rap and get knocked on a lot. As if your music is any better. If you could hear metal through my ears, you would be able to hear its talent, complexity, grit, richness, layers, diversity, passion, and beauty. And I suppose the problem is, if you don't understand it, or don't know how to listen to it, you will probably hate it. But then again, you could diss almost any kind of music, really. Some redneck whining about beer and cheating relationship with twangy guitars. Or some black guy yelling about drugs, guns, and hoes over a repetitive beat. Or some dude singing depressing songs with low-tuned instruments. Girly men with high voices. Dirty hippies too high to make any sense. Annoying generic teen idols who are way more rich and popular than their level of talent deserves. Rebellious kids acting out. A deaf dude who couldn't hear what he was doing. Or scary Satan screaming over broken guitars. I am proud to say that some of my friends, and even family members, are open-minded enough to allow me to give them tastes of metal that not only increases their tolerance, but even lets them able to appreciate some of its characteristics. And even like some of the bands. My mom likes an Iron Maiden song. And just because you don't like one style of metal doesn't mean you hate all of it. In fact, for every genre of music there is a metal version of it. Like pop metal, opera metal, punk metal, avant metal, alternative, folk, stoner, goth, funk, electro, Viking, rap, pirate, hell, there's even children's metal. Well, that's it for today. I hope I gave you something to think about. Toodles. Dun 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 d